a very basic description on how to use a clicker. First, you're going to need a clicker. Now, if you have a box clicker like this, I've not been able to find one that's not very loud. This is extremely loud. It even hurts my ears. So what you need is some poster tack or very many layers of tape to stick over the dimple in the clicker. The next thing you're going to need is a dog. Now you're ready to train with the clicker. To teach a dog the concept of what the click means, you simply need to make the click the predictor that food will soon be following. Now, if the food comes before the click, the dog is not going to find the click the predictor that the food is coming. So to do this, you need to mark, pause, then feed your dog a treat. If you move at the same time with the click and the food, what can happen is the dog can start to think that this means that the food is coming, or this means that the food is coming, and not the noise itself. And that can interfere with your training, and you get a dog that's very fixated on your hands. And as you can see, now that Splash has figured out what I'm doing, she knows that this doesn't mean that the food is coming. So you're going to mark, consciously think, pause, then feed your dog a treat. Now, if you have a very active dog that's moving around, you want to make sure that you're not clicking your dog for doing something that you don't like, because they can quickly learn, oh, every time I do this, she clicks. For example, jumping up or pawing at your hand to get the treat out. Some people skip that step altogether and simply jump into training behaviors using a clicker, and the dog learns the concept as they learn the new behaviors. So for example, a great behavior to teach the dog the concept of what the click means is teaching the dog to touch your hands. Now if you've held treats in your hands and you reach out towards a dog, they most likely will sniff your hand to see if you have a treat in it. And that moment, you can mark with the clicker, then move to feed a treat. If you have a dog that's really chill around food, you can immediately start using the click to predict food and train new behaviors. However, if your dog's getting very excited by the food, you first need to teach your dog to chill and relax around food first before pairing it with the clicker. Because what can happen is if your dog is over-aroused by food and you start pairing the clicker with the food, the click is also going to start making your dog too excited. And what can happen is you'll get a lot of stress signals coming out in your dog in the behaviors that you're teaching, and also your dog could start whining and barking and sometimes even shaking with excitement. And it makes it very frustrating for the dog and the trainer to train new behaviors when the dog is that excited. So the first step is teaching your dog to have the correct level of arousal around food.